So for all those who've been, you know, keeping a track of the news recently, you'll appreciate that we are living in very interesting times. And just to stir things up a little bit, if I may, could I have a show of hands as to how many actually have State Bank of India debit cards? Excellent. Wonderful. The preceding speakers have really spelt out how information technology can transform something which impacts our lives practically from the time we are born through our entire life cycle, and that's healthcare. And increasingly, healthcare is experiencing, like many other sectors, what we refer to as convergence, IT convergence. So information technology has practically revolutionized the way we look at healthcare. Recently Microsoft has joined hands with research groups and saying that look, I think probably going forward the cure to cancer will probably be aided when IT, information technology and analytics joins hands. But coming closer to home, the healthcare industry is increasingly using IT in a very big way. So we are using medical devices, which very few of us realize are, have an IT component. They are generating a huge amount of data, and increasingly in a network world. So this data could be at risk. In fact, along with the financial sector, one of the industries which are increasingly coming under attack world over is the health sector, because of the enormous patient data that it carries. So very clearly, what's happening around the world, and it's the same in the health care, the health industry as well. The users, whether it be the practitioners, that is the healthcare professionals, the doctors, the medical fraternity, or the patients, they are asking for change. They are, they're demanding more transparency. They're demanding more efficiency. Now, we are talking about a mobile world. We want anywhere, anytime computing, and this has resulted in the proliferation of devices. So we use devices practically for anything and everything that we do. And of course, this has driven the development of applications. And where is all this leading to? It's primarily leading to the generation of a huge amount of data. So gone are the days where data would be basically in forms, paper forms, to be filed away in files and cabinets, probably not touched for a very long time. But now, particularly in the healthcare industry, where a patient's record would be kept in digital form and will practically stay there forever. Now, this data really needs to be protected. So, in this information security, space, what we say is it's a combination of people, process, technology. But typically, what we forget is it's all about protecting the data. I could lose my device. My system could crash, but there are two fundamental aspects about data that should not be forgotten, and that is the accessibility to my data, and the data should be available only to those who are authorized to access it. These are the two fundamental requirements when we talk about handling data. So we are looking at a people-centric information technology requirement, and where we basically empower our users, whether it be healthcare professionals or professionals who are primarily supporting the healthcare sector. And this requires a unification of the environment, which means that in an increasingly interconnected world, if security is not a built-in concept, then you could actually face a domino effect. Now, it's a scary world. out there from a cybersecurity perspective, primarily because cybersecurity increasingly, being very important, has not really been taken into account at the core of decision making at the time when systems are designed. And hence, in many cases, organizations generally tend to address cybersecurity issues as bolt-on as against bolt-in. So in this current world of ours, the way things are trending, you have a proliferation of smart devices in a very big way. In fact, today you have more smart phones coming in practically on a monthly basis than you have laptops and other devices. The other areas where innovation is really taking place in a very big way is basically the space of cloud or the cloud space, and there are many players, including Google, Microsoft, Amazon, and some others. But practically these are the three big players. So here there is a lot of innovation which is taking place on the cloud, where primarily now the large data, the big data, is moving on to. Eventually, this is what cyber criminals are targeting. So they primarily are targeting the data, and they are targeting organizations with the primary purpose of carrying out a disruption so that they can make money. As simple as that. Carrying out a criminal activity in cyberspace is quite anonymous. It doesn't take much of an effort. And in today's date and time, a lot of low skill set people have also got into this, primarily because of the way the dark web functions. And hence, this move of organized crime into the cyberspace has increased the threat to organizations by manyfold. And if you really ask me, as an IT security professional, I would say that many organizations, many segments are really not that well prepared, as of date. Now, cybersecurity and business requirements. At the end of the day, cybersecurity and business requirements have to be balanced out. And that entire process of balancing the implementation of cybersecurity vis-a-vis business requirements is best effected through a process known as IT risk management. Unfortunately, 75% of the organizations, and this is a very conservative figure, ladies and gentlemen, in this country, do not carry out an IT risk assessment, or if they have carried out an IT risk assessment, it is not an effective IT risk assessment. And this I see even in the regulated industry, where the performance of an IT risk assessment would be a regulatory requirement, but it is done more of a paper exercise as against an effective activity on ground. Which is why, despite so much amount of effort, resources, and technology that is deployed, you still see enough evidence of organizations getting compromised. IT risk assessment is actually the fundamental exercise which is essential for defining the IT security strategy for any organization. Resources will always be in short supply. Resources in terms of money, resources in terms of skilled manpower, and will always be in short supply. And there will always be a requirement to do basically prioritization. And it is IT risk assessment which actually allows us to define that IT security strategy for a particular organization. And unfortunately, this is the fundamental exercise where organizations are missing out on. And it's precisely because of this reason, even where organizations have spent a large amount of money, their end result is not as effective. Their cyber defenses are not as effective as they should be. And at the end of the day, they do not even end up achieving their business goals and objectives. I've just given some examples on the screen of some of the recent cases of cybersecurity vulnerabilities or breaches that I picked up from the open domain. I've kept four blocks which are empty, and that's because that it's just a simply a question of who's going to be next. So today, increasingly, vendors are coming up with medical equipment which would have an IT component, and primarily because it did not have security as a consideration built into the design of that particular device. At a certain point in time, they realize that it can be exploited in a malicious way. So, I'm sure everybody has heard and read articles on the vulnerability of certain pacemakers of an earlier generation. A lot of patient data is getting stolen. There's a Rainbow Children's Clinic in Texas, and most of this occurrences are just about 2 months and 3 months old. So this, the complete patient's record in this children's clinic in Texas was deleted quite recently. There are, if you go onto the dark web, there are millions of credit card, details which are available for sale. Now, typically what happens is that in any organization, where an entire cycle has to be completed, right from medical records to billing, and use of credit cards. So typically, there would be a lot of personal information which would be stored even in the health sector, in a health organization's records. That could lead to a compromise of sensitive medical information. That could lead to compromise of financial information. That could even lead to compromise of people's credit card information. So going forward, as the health sector moves towards a converged information technology environment, it is extremely important that IT security becomes an integral part of their entire digital transformation strategy. So I have used another term called digital transformation strategy, and as an auditor, as an IT risk management profession, I work across multiple segments. I work with health segment customers, with BFSI, with the manufacturing space, and with the government as well. And I have yet to come across a single organization in our country which truly has a mature digital transformation strategy. So if an organization does not have a mature, at least a 3 to 4 year ahead looking digital transformation strategy, it cannot have an effective IT strategy. And if it doesn't have an effective IT strategy backed by an effective IT risk management strategy, then that organization probably will end up spending a lot of money on information technology, but will may not be able to achieve the result that they envisioned or they desire. This is a KPMG report of last year, and this clearly shows these sectors which are increasingly under attack. Now, one thing is very funny here, isn't it? Healthcare does not really spell out as a separate sector. So I think the realization that health, the healthcare industry, is an extremely important industry from an IT security perspective needs to be realized not only by the healthcare industry but by folks outside the healthcare industry as well. But having said so, I would put the healthcare industry along with pharmaceutical. So these are the systems which are increasingly coming under attacks, right? It's email servers, desktop laptops, mobiles. Nobody can literally function without these today. Web servers, ERP systems, file servers. In the case of the manufacturing sector, you have something known as SCADA systems. Now, you will ask me, what is the relevance of SCADA system when it comes to the healthcare? There are, when you do an automation, when you want to carry out an automation of a facility, and increasingly modern medical facilities will get automated, right? They do require something known as industrial controllers for automating certain tasks. You could have an automated facility where doors are opened, closed remotely. The complete the environmental system is managed remotely. Walls are closed and shut remotely. It's all SCADA system. So SCADA systems would be very, very relevant even to a modern healthcare facility. And many of these systems were never designed with security in mind. So increasingly, this is something, these are the IT risks which basically need to be understood and need to be handled. Now, this is a very boring slide. It's a plain vanilla slide, but this says it all. The reason why most of the organizations today, and not just in the health sector, but in the financial sector, are facing problems is because they have failed to address basic issues around cybersecurity, basic fundamental controls around cybersecurity. So, for example, I already spoke about the lack of a digital transformation, strategy, ineffective risk management processes, lack of data classification and associated technical controls, lack of timely upgradation of technology. So many of this ATM thing that we are reading about, I'm not sure everybody is aware, most of these ATMs are running on operating system which has reached its end of shelf life a long time back. Now, the fact of the matter is technology has its life, and at some point in time you move forward. So you timely upgradation of technology is extremely important for managing IT risks as well. Improper endpoint hardening. That means you use laptops in hospitals today, you would be using tab handled devices for accessing patient record. They are running in default configuration stage. So that is their status, and they become an entry point for malware very easily into the system. Identity access management. So basically, identity management is again a core fundamental aspect of handling security. It's one person, one identity. That's how we do it in the physical world, right? We don't have 20 iCards to enter our own office, but in the IT world, you may have 70 applications across the ecosystem, the IT ecosystems, and there are multiple identities that a person may have. It's a nightmare. It results in improper provisioning and deprovisioning of accounts over a period of time. It may end up creating a huge repository of ghost accounts which have administrator privileges. It's a disaster that has already probably happened. Today we have, I don't think we can do without our mobile devices. So many organizations have a BYOD policy. So BYOD is bring your own device, right? Or a mobile device. So many organizations do have a BYOD policy, but it's not effectively implemented. So that's another problem. Eventually, it is about trust. If I don't trust my system adequately, then how do I effectively function? Or if I trust my system blindly, whereas it is probably not worthy of trust, then that also is a problem. So just in concluding, this is typically the state of how an identity access management is handled, haphazard, right? This is how it should be. This is how it should be. So with that, I will conclude my talk. Thank you so much.